everybody, and welcome back to the Chan Chan, and welcome to my new gaming room. Yes, it's finally done. I can't believe how long this took to set up, get everything together, and buy everything. So everything behind me, you know, I purchased myself. I can't really hear anything that I'm saying. But everything behind me, I purchased myself. I've been saving like a madman for the last few months to get all this together. Been waiting for things to come in the mail. Some things got lost in the mail. Some things arrived damaged. But yes, the room is finally done. So I'm really excited to start doing some streaming, start playing some more video games. And I know that a lot of you in the comments section of when I was announcing that I was doing a gaming channel, a lot of people were like, oh, you're randomly doing a gaming channel or posing gamer poser. And it's like, dude, I grew up playing video games. I grew up playing the old school Atari computer games like Dungeon Master and Monopoly and Wheel of Fortune and stuff. Grew up with the original Nintendo, Sega, PlayStation, Nintendo 64, when Xbox came out, all those kind of systems. I'd say my favorite system of all time has to be the PlayStation. The PlayStation just had so many games on there that I absolutely love, like Spyro, Tomba, heck, even Prabba the Rapper. There was so many good games on there. And favorite game of all time, I'm gonna say, is definitely still Halo for me. Hands down, Halo was like such a revolutionary game. That Xbox Live feature when it first came out was like mind-blowing, and it was so awkward hearing the other person on the other end. But I was still playing video games, and I still kind of had this rule to myself where every Sunday was like fun video game night, and I would order some pizza and some good junk food. And I'd be playing PC games like Dota 2, playing that to like 5-6 o'clock in the morning, playing World of Warcraft, and then obviously making time to play some console games like PlayStation and Xbox and such, like Diablo 3, Borderlands. Excited to get back into it. Let's play some games I've never played before, games that have been on my list, and I thought this would just be a super fun experience to just dive right back into video games, dive right back into my roots. Brought some of my toy friends here too. Got my Street Shark, got some Alien and Pac-Man, a little Spyro over here. So let us start the tour. Let us start the royal tour. So the first thing that we're gonna take a look at is this awesome gaming desk. I grabbed this off of Amazon. I was particularly looking for an adjustable desk just to have that option if I wanna adjust something. So this desk did come with a mouse mat that covered the entire desk, but I opted not to use that and just wanted to use this one instead. Next up is this FicMax gaming chair. It was really nice because they did have the options for a lot of different colors, and I've been using it, you know, off and on for a little bit for editing, and so far I have no complaints with this chair. And it does also have this little footstool feature that does come out on the bottom, and the chair also has this vibrating cushion feature, which is actually pretty cool, with this little USB. And I didn't realize it came with this feature, so I must have bypassed it in the description. Next up are these dual MSI Optix 27-inch monitors. It's really cool to have kind of a dual setup here. I've never had a dual monitor setup before. They're 1440 resolution and have 165 refresh rate. And I mounted those bad boys with a dual monitor desk mount. So as most of you out there know, it's really, really hard right now to find a decent graphics card. So I unfortunately had to get this pre-built, which was not ideal for me, but it worked. And I managed to also get that 3080 video card in there, which was so hard to find. I've been on, you know, the Discord sites that gives you a little notification, you know, when they come up on Amazon or Best Buy or something. And for the life of me, I could not get my hands on a 3080 video card. So I opted to get this pre-built, which definitely ended up working out in my favor. So for the keyboard, I picked up this cheap Rosewill RGB keyboard. I really liked it because it worked with my color setup. I'm not super, you know, into this keyboard, so I might just end up using one of my SteelSeries or Razer keyboards that I have with my older PCs. So yeah, I just picked it up because it was super cute with that white and pink color pattern that I was going for. For the headphones, I decided to finally upgrade to these Razer Kraken Kitty RGB headphones. I really, really always wanted these. I always thought they looked so cute. And I also grabbed the base station as well, and I got these both on Amazon, and I won't tell you how much I paid for them because I'm kind of ashamed of how much I spent on these kitty earphones. Shh. So for the mouse and the mouse pad, I grabbed the Razer Death Adder gaming mouse and the extended gaming mouse pad. I really, really like the colors on these. Obviously, they go with my white and pink theme again, and I just love that color around the edges of the mouse mat. So for the camera, I did a ton of research on what camera I should get for streaming. I knew I wanted to get a new camera because I didn't want to go back and forth between my toy room and my gaming room, but I found a Sony A5100 on Amazon for a decent price. So I went with that. I was actually surprised how cheap it was, and I think it was about $450 Canadian. So to go with the camera, I also grabbed a newer 18-inch ring light with a stand. I saw that a lot of other streamers were doing this, so I thought it just made sense to kind of do what already works. So some other accessories that I got was an Elgato Stream Deck. I don't really know the full potential of this thing. I don't really know how to work it, but from all my research from other people's streaming setups, they said that this was like a must have for your setup. It's just like a bunch of all like pre-recorded actions that, you know, you just press this button and it does like, you know, 10 things at a time if you want it to program it. So again, I just don't really know how to use it, but I know it's a must have. And I also grabbed some capture cards. I have a 4K USB and I also have an Elgato HD60S Plus. I'm not really sure which one to use. I'm not sure which one's, you know, best in this situation or that. So that's just something I have to play around with in the future and see kind of what works for me. For lighting, I grabbed a 2-pack of newer adjustable lights. I actually have these for my toy room when I am filming in there, and I really like them to have, you know, the features of going warm and cool and just like the dimness as well. I really like the adjustability on that. So I grabbed two more for my room here. So I grabbed those lights off of Amazon. I think a 2-pack is like $150 Canadian, if I'm not mistaken. I will again leave everything down below. I grabbed these Amazon basic tripod stands, and so far they seem to be working for me, but they're not the best stands for the lights, but they work for me. And for Zim microphone, I just planned on using my Blue Yeti USB blackout edition with this Rode swivel boom arm that is going to be really handy for, you know, moving it around. And I also grabbed a shock mount for this. And again, everything was from Amazon. And because my computer setups are usually chaos, you know, with all the cords and tripping around everything, and I can't keep track of stuff down there, I decided to grab some of these under the desk management trays off of Amazon as well. This giant power bar is possibly the most handy thing ever. So this was definitely a must have with all those plugins that I have. And you all know how much I love my LED lights. I have them all in my toy room and they work fantastic for me. But this time around, I decided to grab some new ones from Amazon. They're called Kiko. And for the love of God, one of these strip lights is not working, but I'm way too tired and lazy to kind of troubleshoot that right now. So in the future, I'm gonna have to fix that, I guess. So I hope you all enjoyed today's video. I know I did because I'm very excited that this is all finally put together. And if you are interested in any of the products that I have shown today, I will leave links down below if you're interested in, you know, kind of upgrading your current gaming setup, or you just saw something, you're like, oh, that's cool, I want to look into that. So I will leave links down below in my description. And as well, if you're interested in following me on my new gaming venture here, you can follow me on Twitch, which I have left a link to in my description as well, and my new YouTube channel, Lore Legends Gaming. And in the comments down below, please let me know your favorite video game of all time. Mine is definitely Halo. I have so many good memories playing that, you know, just hidden under the blanket, got some pizza, and just like playing together with my brother and stuff. So definitely great memories playing that game. So I'd love to know your favorite video game in the comments down below. So please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. I come out with new videos every week. Come check me out on social media and help support the channel on Patreon. So thank you all so much for watching and stay legendary.